Hare Krishna.
We live in a world which is rife with temptation. And such temptation can captivate and degrade us at any moment. And sometimes we may feel, what can I do? I can't live with closed eyes. So, how can I function in a world which is filled with so many temptations? For applying the answer to this question, we need to understand how temptation leads to agitation. We might think it is a one-step event, that we see something tempting and immediately we feel agitated. Yes, it can seem to happen so fast that it appears like a one-step event, but it is not a one-step event. It is actually a two-step event. And two-step event means, actually not even two-step, there are multiple steps, as the Bhagavad-Gita speaks in the second chapter, 62 and 63 verses. So, dhyayato vishayan pumsaha sangasteshu pajayate sangat sanjayate kamaha kamat krodho bijayate krodhat bhavati sammoha sammohat smuti vibhramaha smuti bhramashat buddhinasho buddhinashat pranashyati. So, dhyayato is perception. Actually, drushyato would have been perception. Dhyayato is contemplation. And what transforms perception into contemplation is either the investment of the mind or the investment of the intelligence. The intelligence is involved with analysis, and the mind is involved with imagination. So either of those get invested, then the whatever is perceived gets internalized into our consciousness deeper and longer. So usually whenever we see temptation, if our intelligence were activated, then we would analyze and then we would realize this is not worth it. This is not what I want to do. But instead our imagination gets activated. And when that happens, when the imagination is fueled, then we start getting carried away by that. So dhyayato vishayan pumsaha sangasteshu pajayate, as we start imagining, then we start thinking, hey, that's nice. I'd like to enjoy it. Sangat sanjayate kamaha. Oh, I want it. Not just nice, but I want it. Kamat krodho bijayate. And sort of, who says I can't have it? And we start imagining somebody restraining us and start fighting against them. Angry at their unfairness and their outrageousness in trying to deprive us of the pleasure. And by there, it can needn't be people out there, it can be our own moral restraints. And then, like that, the trajectory goes down. It is through our imagination that we get pulled down further and further. And what happens eventually is, krodhat bhavati sammoha, then it leads to delusion. And then the whole trajectory goes on. When we are deluded, so mohat smuti vibhrama, our memory gets obscured. So our imagination can obfuscate our recollection. So instead of recollecting how in the past our intelligences have been futile and even counterproductive, then what happens? Krodhat, then after that it goes on, smuti brahmashad buddhi nasho, then our intelligence is destroyed. At this point, we are not capable of analysis because our consciousness is aflame. The imagination has taken over our consciousness and buddhi nashat pranashyati, we fall. So basically, this whole trajectory we analyze to understand that even if we can't stop perception, we can stop the imagination. And our faculty for imagination, if we can learn to check it and rather redirect it elsewhere, then we won't be so carried away by our mind, our senses, and we can become purified, elevated, and ultimately liberated. Thank you. Hare Krishna.